you know, part of what drew me to Maine, or had me have the inspiration to go somewhere where we could do something agricultural, was, you know, I read a lot of Wendell Berry and his whole life has been devoted to this issue, the economies of scale, and how it actually undermines our experience, our life, the quality of our life. One of the quotes that I shared with you earlier was, when going backwards makes sense, it's progress.
Up until 3 years ago, Maine and Canada were producing about 250 million pounds of wild blueberries. The last 3 years, Maine and Canada have produced over 400 million pounds each crop. And if we had 1 year that was 400 million pounds, that wouldn't be a problem, but to have 3 years in a row where your market is at 250 million, now it's jumped to, jumped over 400 million, and it's created a tremendous surplus of blueberries.
You know, this situation with the blueberries where we're overproducing to the point where you can't even make a living, you're hiring migrant workers, is, let's go back to the scale at which it worked for families, and economically there was a scale at which it worked.
Think around here, all the different farms there have been, and right now there's a few dairy farms left, but they're becoming fewer and fewer. And blueberries is, in some of the areas around here, kind of the last, which is a commercial agriculture that's happening. So we're really losing our agricultural heritage in the area. So blueberries helps to keep that alive. It's, you know, when you think that at the turn of the century, 1900, over 50% of the people were involved with agriculture. And today, in 2017, less than 2% of the population's involved with agriculture. So that's quite a change. The blueberries canning business really started with the Civil War. The first wild blueberries were canned to send to the Union troops. And that's basically what started wild blueberries in Maine as being canned. But the very beginning, people used to, back with the old Model T trucks, they used to actually a lot of times set up tents in the blueberry fields. Some people would be raking, and some people would be sitting under the tents, and they would winnow, clean the blueberries, and put them in like quart baskets. And then that night, the Model T would be loaded with all these boxes of blueberries, and they would head off for either Boston or New York City. For the markets there.
Well, back if, for me, growing up in the mid-coast area here, of course, Knox County area, in the 60s, when we were harvesting blueberries, it was all local people a lot of people would take maybe time off from work, or housewives would schedule it so that they could come out and help rake. Like I was saying, back in 1957, before I was even a year old, my mother took me out in the blueberry field, put me in a playpen with an umbrella while she was running the harvesting crew.
So when kids went to work in the blueberry fields, if they needed a winter coat or a pair of boots or shoes or a new pair of pants or something, if they earned that money, that was less money that came out of the parents' income. So raking blueberries actually really contributed to what the family needed. So it was part of a family support system, I would say.
In the 70s, it started picking up kids more in school buses that go around, and it became less of a family coming out in the 70s, and more high school kids that would gather, maybe down at the shopping center in Camden, which at the time was like the IGA. Bill Hardy would pick us up down there, or at the end of Mullinar Road out by Hosmer Pond, he'd come by and pick us up on the way. But he was using a school bus by then. That was nice. You got to sit inside. But he was mostly just going around picking up the high school people. The family stopped coming out.
In the 70s, it kind of changed around where it was mostly high school kids working blueberries. And you would have a few adults. And then in the early 90s, we had our first migrant crews come in because all of a sudden there wasn't enough local people to rake all the crop.
Right. And we started hiring farm labor contractors. Farm labor contractors would bring people in from down south. Some of them would come up from picking cultivated blueberries in New Jersey or North Carolina. After they got done with us, they'd go and pick apples somewhere. They'd plant trees out in the forest. So we've moved away from families coming out to harvest in the 60s, all the way to picking up high school kids with everything that we had through the 80s and 90s. To just hiring farm labor contractors now.
But kind of like your situation, your dad said about raking blueberries, say, for college. I earned my college tuition raking blueberries. Everyone on a crew becomes like a family. Everybody kind of. So when I was a young kid raking blueberries, I was put with an adult. And adults taught us how to rake and made sure we didn't miss one blueberry.
Actually, my grandfather on my mother's side grew wild blueberries when I was born. He was growing wild blueberries on his own land. But I started out, my mother was running a harvesting crew when she was 18 years old. They'd take me out and put me in a playpen out in the blueberry field. I think by the time that I was 9 or so, I'd go out and rake on a crew run by somebody local here. And so I started raking out in the blueberry fields then.
A lot of people, blueberries were a big part of their childhood. We had somebody up here who raked blueberries for the Cutting family in the 50s who was in his 80s and was out here, and he pointed this part of the field. I raked right there when I was your age, which is pretty cool.
Wow, yeah.
And so a lot of people come back and remember their summers raking blueberries, and so it's that kind of point of reference for people.
Yeah.
What does happen when I go out in the fields, because I've been working in the same fields over and over, it's kind of like ghosts following you around in the field, because you'll see a certain rock or something and they will trigger memories of the past. And it's, so I don't know how else to describe it other than it's like all these memories are like ghosts that keep coming back.
Yeah.
You may see me walking across the field and all of a sudden have a big smile on my face because something triggered a memory from the past. when I was a kid raking, it was very important. The old saying, everyone says, oh, we rake blueberries to buy school clothes. Well, it was a little more important than that. It was, you know, families work together.
Yeah, so that tradition of like doing that every summer, is that kind of dying out, or?
With the local people, it is dead.
Yeah.
Unfortunately. So that's a part of our culture that we've lost. And that part is kind of sad.
The irony of being living in a time when the economies of scale of blueberry production have actually removed the opportunity for young people to grow up with the appreciation of that sort of agricultural awareness is really something. I think being respectful of the whole cycle of what that plant means and where you're from, and these things are important for you guys to consider, especially your generation, where I think you're starting to ask the right questions about climate change and all of the life-threatening existence issues that you're going to have are because of economies of scale, you know, that we don't live appropriately upon the land that we live in, you know, within.
All right, how would you describe the blueberry season in one word or sentence?
Tiring, but at the same time, fun, I guess.
Blueberry season is fun. I don't know, it's just fun.
Hard work, rewarding.
It's just like fun winnowing and like raking blueberries, sometimes picking them and eating them.
And are you glad that you do blueberries in the summer?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, I am.
Helps my family, and I enjoy it.
Like, people just talk about it at school and stuff, and then you're like, yeah, I rake those blueberries. And then you feel all good about yourself because you rake them.
I've been doing it for so long that it just kind of, part of my summer, it would just not be fun without it.
Woo!